You've been hit by, right. You've been hit by a smooth
He's looking dancing, man. He's hitting that. So I don't know. I guess there might be a few more silly TikToks on here than I thought there would be, but that's funny, man.
I guess that's the first one. Just keep going.
What's the risk that we are watching the beginning of another Cold War, and is there now a complete rupture in U.S. and Russian relations?
There is a complete rupture right now in U.S.-Russian relations.
Okay, good to know.
If they continue on this path that they're on. And in terms of a Cold War, that depends. You have the vast majority of the rest of the world in total opposition to what he's doing. From Asia to South America to Europe to around the world. And so it's going to be a cold day for Russia. The idea, you don't see a whole lot of people coming to his defense.
Cold day for Russia. I kind of like the way he said that. It's going to be a cold day for Russia. Okay. Okay. I stopped shining, said I'm
not ready. Party. Dear Putin, let's speed up to the part where you kill yourself. Nah, that's wow. I mean, you know, shout out the people of Ukraine, bro. That's good stuff right there. Hard, bro. So I've heard a little bit of the ghost of Kiev, you know, just the fighter pilot that's been shooting down a bunch of Russian, you know, jets or whatever, fighter jets. Oh, no. Yeah, you know, I just feel like celebrities, a lot of the times, they're kind of out of touch. Ukraine, you know, God protect the people of Ukraine. Here's my new lip gloss, like, come on, just at least give it some time, you know. Wow. Okay, he's still there. I thought he got ran over for a second. So he's in that car right there, I'm guessing. Oh, is that him? That's him right there. It's not even the car. The car must have been just on the other road. There's literally a dude there punching their tanks. Or not their tanks, but, you know, their cars or whatever, vehicles. And at least they're avoiding him, you know. I was fully ready to see some guy get ran over. So at least they're supporting him. But still, man. Dude. So I see him. He's there. So ignore the car. He's, like, right there. That's crazy. That's honestly crazy.
The U.S. says that it can't rule out that Russia won't attack NATO. Today, the U.S. announced that it's now deploying troops to Poland, Germany, and Romania, with more deployments possible. France also sending troops to Romania. Earlier today, the U.K. intercepted 4 Russian strategic bombers. The U.S. has offered Russia arms control agreements in exchange for Russia ending its illegal occupations of Crimea, Moldova, and Georgia. Though it's unlikely Russia...
So what I'm hearing is, like, or what I've heard is that we haven't put any troops in Ukraine, but we're obviously putting, stationing troops outside to kind of watch over. But since Ukraine's not part of NATO, it's kind of a sticky situation. But we have been helping them in terms of, like, guns and stuff like that. So
Russia will accept the offer. The Brazilian and Argentinian presidents are being pressured by the U.S. to not travel to Russia. And the U.S. has asked for an emergency meeting of the U.N. Security Council to discuss North Korea's missile test. And it's all a backdrop to the larger story that the U.S. says that it can't rule out that Russia...
Yeah, I mean, if Russia attacks NATO, that's essentially World War III, so that's wild. So.
This is crazy. It's always cool to see, you know, just another country getting along with your country and vice versa. That's cool to see, man, the 2 flags. Pictures. That's cool, man. I'm glad they're treated well.
Oh, no.
Yeah, this is definitely current from right now. I know some of the troops that we sent.
Today, we got a static display here in downtown Zagan, Poland. So, a local Polish unit brought out their vehicles, as you can see here. And we brought out a few of our Bradleys and a Humvee, kind of just a welcoming ceremony and showing that our units are cohesive and here to work together and continue to train. I'm excited, you know, like, there's a lot of good training. It's a very professional military, you know, They got a lot of real good equipment. They got like a lot of equipment that can be compared to ours without being the same. So it leaves a lot to learn from in the training, especially for myself and my soldiers. It's awesome.
It's cool to see them like interacting with people, you know, with civilians and stuff like that.
Fuck in the school with Tommy. Always in a barbershop. She can't hear about this. She can't hear about that. My boy, a BDM.
So obviously, Chief Keef, you know, don't really need to explain that. But yeah, that's funny. That's a good one. That's crazy, man. Bro, imagine being in your house or your apartment or whatever, and you just see a Russian tank straight in the grass, not even on the road, just in the grass in front of your place. And well, it looks like she's like, he or she is scared to like be recording, but that's crazy, man. Oh, hold up. In the comments, it says Ukraine. It's a Ukrainian tank. So Ukrainian tank. So still, though, I mean, the fact that, you know, you got to have your country has to start throwing tanks where you live. That's wild. Love to see it, man. So they're obviously shooting down a fighter jet or whatever. Yeah, they have not at all back down, you know, they're fighting through it, which is good.
Oh.
I didn't see it. I have not seen this WWE. Yeah, okay, yeah. That's pretty funny in the context. I knew something was going to happen, but I've never seen that WWE clip before. So, yeah, that's pretty funny. But obviously making light of the serious situation that's going on. 21 years old, and he is fighting for his country. He is the only soldier guarding this footbridge, and he feels terrified for his family after Russian forces surrounded his village. Look at him, man, alone, right there on the bridge.
There are a Russian base in my village. And from my village, they're gonna go here on Kyiv to capture it.
Bro, that sucks, man. Like, honestly, that's crazy. Look how he just sounds so scared too.
Yeah, it's I hope he makes it, bro. Scary and terrifying. I am called to my parents. They really scared. There's Russians in our village, enemies. There's tanks, heavy vehicle. I hope that they will be fine.
So, I guess, just footage. That's pretty good. It's wild that we're watching this on TikTok right now, but that's crazy. Well, I guess just someone's getting shot down.
This is a soldier.
Oh, that's crazy. That's wild.
His pockets, what it look like? These are the patches of soil. These are the patches he says he's taken from.
Russian Federation.
Dude, what? That's crazy.
Can we see that one? That appears to have a Russian flag on it.
That's crazy.
These are from the Russian soldiers?
Yes.
So when they kill him, I guess he's just going and looting their bodies, bro. That's wild to think about, but honestly, shout out to him, man. You gotta do what you gotta do. Motivate yourself, you know. And when someone invades your home, you're not gonna be careful with them or anything. Like you're gonna own them. So that's crazy to think about, though, for real. So this is a Russian boat kind of broadcasting to the Ukrainians, I guess. It says, otherwise I will open fire. Do you copy?
Sure.
Well, this is it.
Right, tell him to F himself. Oh, bro. Yo, that's wild, man. That's crazy. And, you know, what's actually sad is in the comments, at least, people are saying, and obviously from the video, what I'm gauging is, you know, they didn't survive that. Like, they got fired upon. And so those are, like, pretty much, you know, last words. That's got to be the coolest way to go out, the most honorable way to go out, in my opinion. I mean, that's just bad to the core. I rewatch that. Oh, they're wearing an open fire. Who said just in case? I don't know. That's wild, man. That's powerful, for real. Powerful, honorable, and brave, to say the least. Alright, that's all I got, y'all. Thank y'all for watching. Like and subscribe for more, and just pray for everyone in Ukraine, and pray for the people in Russia, because I know we're bashing them a lot right now, but I know a lot of people in Russia don't even want the war. So, yeah, man, pray for a more peaceful solution, and hopefully this is as bad as it gets. So, thank y'all for watching. If y'all made it this far, like and subscribe, and peace out.